हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू प्रशांत आईएएस। सो फ्रेंड्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव कंप्लीटेड आवर डिस्कशन विद द स्पीकर एंड डेप्यूटी स्पीकर ऑफ लोकसभा, एंड इन दिस क्लास वी विल स्टार्ट आवर डिस्कशन विद डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ बिल्स। ओके, सो टुडेज टॉपिक इज डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ बिल्स, एंड फ्रेंड्स वी विल कंपेयर ऑल दीज बिल्स based on some parameters. Okay, so here the parameters are given. So here the parameters are given, and here on the top the types of bills are given. Okay, so now let's start. So friends, first comes the ordinary bill. After ordinary bill, then comes money bill. After that, finance bill category A. Okay, it is also known as finance bill category 1. So you can call it finance bill category A or finance bill category 1. Okay, now there is one more type of finance bill. It is known as finance bill category B, or you can also call it as finance bill category 2. Okay, so here in this table I have not listed finance bill category B or finance bill category 2, because we will discuss about finance bill category B separately. Okay, so here I have only listed finance bill category A, and then comes constitutional amendment bill. Okay, so in all you can say that there are 5 type of bills: ordinary bill, money bill, finance bill category A, or we can also call it as finance bill category 1. After that, finance bill category B, or we can also call it as finance bill category 2, and then comes constitutional amendment bill. So friends, first of all, let us discuss about all these bills one by one in detail, and then we will compare these bills on the basis of certain parameters. So first of all, we will discuss about the meaning of these bills. So what is the meaning of ordinary bill? Okay, so what is the meaning of ordinary bill? So friends, ordinary bill is any bill. Okay, so we can say that ordinary bill is any bill other than the remaining 3 bills. So ordinary bill is any bill other than remaining 3 bills. Now what does it mean? So it means that if a bill is not money bill, if a bill is not finance bill category A or finance bill category B, okay, so we can group the finance bills together. Okay, so if a bill is not money bill, and if a bill is not finance bill category A or finance bill category B, and if a bill is also not constitutional amendment bill, then we can say that that bill is ordinary bill. So what is the definition of ordinary bill? So ordinary bill means any bill other than the remaining bills. Any bill other than the remaining bills means if a bill is not money bill, if a bill is not finance bill category A or finance bill category B, if a bill is even not constitutional amendment bill, then that bill is ordinary bill. So what is ordinary bill? So ordinary bill is any bill other than the remaining bills. So friends, then the next question is that where this bill can be introduced. Okay, so first of all, I have taught you about the meaning of ordinary bill, then we need to know that where ordinary bill can be introduced. So the answer to this question is that ordinary bill can be introduced either in Lok Sabha or in Rajya Sabha. Okay, so ordinary bill can be introduced in Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha. So it means that in the matter of the introduction of ordinary bill, both the houses, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, have equal power. Okay, so we can summarize that ordinary bill can either be introduced in Lok Sabha or it can also be introduced in Rajya Sabha. Now friends, then what is the next question? So our next question is that whether the recommendation of president is needed before the introduction of bill in the house. Okay, so what is our next question? So the next question is that whether the recommendation of president is needed before the introduction of the house in the bill. Now what does it mean? So it means that whether the permission of the president of India is needed or not needed before the introduction of this bill in the parliament. So the answer to this question is that the recommendation of the, okay, so what happens that generally the recommendation of the president is not required. Okay, so what happens generally that the recommendation of the president for the introduction of ordinary bill in either house of the parliament is not required. Okay, now what does it mean? It means that before introducing ordinary bill in the parliament, the permission of the president is not needed. It is not required. But friends, इफ अ ऑर्डिनरी बिल इज अ बिल अंडर आर्टिकल 3 of the Indian Constitution. Okay, so listen to my words carefully. That if a ordinary bill is the bill under Article 3 of the Indian Constitution, then the recommendation of the President is needed before the introduction of bill in the House. Now, what is Article 3? So, basically, Article 3 is related to the power of Parliament for the creation of new states. Okay, for changing the area, boundary, or name of the existing states. Okay, means actually Parliament has the power to change the name of any state. Article 3 provides the power. Okay, so here we are discussing about Article 3. So Article 3 actually provides the power to Parliament. Okay, it provides the power to Parliament to make any new state. Parliament can make any new state. Parliament can change the name of any state. Parliament can change the boundary of any state. Okay, Parliament can even change the area of any state. So, if a bill is related to these topics, means if an ordinary bill is related to Article 3, then the permission of the President is needed for the introduction of such bill. Otherwise, the President's recommendation is not needed for the introduction of ordinary bill. President's recommendation will only be needed when a bill is under Article 3, when an ordinary bill is under Article 3. Now, friends, let's see what's our next question. So friends, the next question is that which majority is needed for the passage of this bill? Okay, means which majority is needed for passing the bill in Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha? Which type of majority is needed for passing this bill? So the answer to this question is that the simple majority is needed for passing this bill in either house of the parliament. Means if a ordinary bill is to be passed by Lok Sabha, then Lok Sabha will pass it by simple majority. Similarly, if an ordinary bill is to be passed by Rajya Sabha, then Rajya Sabha will also pass it by simple majority. Now, what is simple majority? So I have taught you this earlier also in a much detailed manner. So simple majority means more than 50% of the members present and voting. Okay, so what is simple majority? So simple majority simply means more than 50% of the members present and voting. Okay, so what you have to do, actually you have to see that how many members are present in the house. Okay, then you have to see that how many members actually casted the vote, because it is also a possibility that the members who are present, so some members will not cast their vote. So you have to see that out of all the members present, how many members have casted their vote. Okay, so this number will be called present and voting. So present and voting means the members who were present in the house on the day of voting, as well as they casted their vote. So what you have to do, you have to calculate the 50% of this number. You have to calculate 50% of this number, and more than 50% will give us the value of simple majority. So the ordinary bill is passed by simple majority in both the houses of parliament. So friends, now our next question is the legislative powers with respect to passing the bill. Now what does it mean? It means that which house has more power for the passing of ordinary bill, whether Lok Sabha is more powerful than Rajya Sabha in the matter of ordinary bill, or Rajya Sabha is more powerful than Lok Sabha in the matter of ordinary bill. Or the third condition can also be that both the houses have equal power. So what is the condition here? So if we are talking of ordinary bill, then we can say that the powers of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha are equal in the matter of ordinary bill. Okay, so the power of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha are equal for the passing of ordinary bill. Means neither Lok Sabha has less powers than Rajya Sabha, nor Rajya Sabha has less powers than Lok Sabha. Both the houses of the parliament, Lok Sabha as well as Rajya Sabha, both have equal powers in passing the ordinary bill. Okay, so here the powers of both the houses of parliament is equal. Now friends, then the next question is that what will happen in the case of deadlock? Okay, what will happen in the case of deadlock on this ordinary bill? Okay, in the case of deadlock between Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha on ordinary bill. Now what is the meaning of deadlock? सो डेडलॉक बेसिकली मींस व्हेन देयर इज अ डिसएग्रीमेंट बिटवीन लोकसभा एंड राज्यसभा. ओके सो दिस इज लोकसभा एंड दिस इज राज्यसभा. नाउ लोकसभा इज सेइंग समथिंग एल्स, राज्यसभा इज सेइंग समथिंग एल्स. सो देयर इज अ फाइनल डिसएग्रीमेंट बिटवीन लोकसभा एंड राज्यसभा ऑन द पासिंग ऑफ दिस ऑर्डिनरी बिल. ओके सो व्हेन देयर इज अ डिसएग्रीमेंट between the two houses of parliament, and basically definitely we have only two houses of the parliament. So when there is a disagreement between the houses of parliament, between Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha on the passing of ordinary bill, okay, then this situation is known as deadlock. Okay, and please don't worry, even if you are not getting what is the meaning of deadlock, then I will take a separate class for deadlock. Okay, why? Because it is an important topic, that what happens in the case of deadlock. Okay, so when there is a disagreement between Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha in the matter of ordinary bill, or in the case of deadlock, what will happen? So the joint sitting, okay, so what will happen, that the joint sitting of both the houses of parliament will be arranged. The joint sitting of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha will be arranged, and then the matter will be decided in that joint sitting. Now, what is the meaning of joint sitting? So, joint sitting basically mean when all the members of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha sit together at a place, okay, and they together decide that what is to be done with that bill. Okay, so joint sitting means when both the houses of parliament are sitting together, all the members of both the houses of parliament are sitting together and they are discussing and deciding on any issue. So this is the meaning of the joint sitting. Okay, so friends, now the next question is regarding the presidential assent. Okay, now what does it mean? So it means that when a bill is passed by both the houses of parliament, when a bill is passed by Lok Sabha as well as Rajya Sabha, and then the bill is sent for the assent of the president, means for the signature of the president. So which options do president have when a bill is sent for his assent? Okay, so actually a bill becomes law only when it gets the assent of the president, means only when it gets the signature of the president. So what is the condition of presidential assent in the case of ordinary bill? So actually friends, in the matter of ordinary bill, president has all the available options. Okay, now what are these options? So the first option with the president has is that president can give his assent. Okay, president can give his assent to that bill. Okay, so giving the assent means president has actually signed on that bill. So when president will give his assent to that bill, so what will happen? That bill will be actually enacted. Means now that bill has become law. Now that bill has become law. Okay, so first option that president has is that president can give his assent. Now what is the second option which president has? So the second option which president has is that president can apply absolute veto on that ordinary bill. Okay, so the second option is that president can apply absolute veto on that ordinary bill. Now what is the meaning of absolute veto? So absolute veto means president totally denies that I will not sign on this bill, I will not give assent to this bill. Okay, but friends, president can apply absolute veto only on the advice of council of ministers. Okay, means president cannot apply absolute veto in his own discretion. President can only apply absolute veto only on the advice of Union Council of Ministers. Now friends, the third option which president has is president can even apply suspensive veto on this type of bill. Okay, so president can even apply suspensive veto on the ordinary bill. Now what is the meaning of suspensive veto? So suspensive veto actually means, what is the meaning of suspensive veto? So suspensive veto actually means when president of India actually sends the bill back to the parliament. Okay, president sends the bill back to the parliament for the reconsideration of the parliament. Okay, now here president can either send this bill to parliament with some recommendations, with some suggestions, or even president can send this bill back to parliament without any recommendation or suggestion. So suspensive veto basically means when president actually sends the bill back to the parliament for the reconsideration of parliament. Means president is saying to parliament that please reconsider once on this bill. So this is the meaning of suspensive veto. Now there is one more option which president has in the matter of in the matter of this ordinary bill. So what is this option? So this last option is the pocket veto. Okay, so what is this last option? So this last option is actually is pocket veto. Now friends, what is the meaning of pocket veto? So pocket veto basically means that president allowing the bill to stay on his table for an indefinite period without giving his assent. This action is known as the application of pocket veto. So in simple words, we can say that president has simply put the bill in his pocket. Okay, so president has simply put the bill in his pocket. As the name suggests that this is pocket veto. So what president has done that he has put the bill in his pocket. He has put bill in his pocket and he totally ignores the bill. Neither he is giving his assent to the bill, nor he is saying that I will not give my assent, nor he is sending the bill back to parliament for the reconsideration. Okay, so what he is doing, he is just ignoring the bill. Okay, so this type of veto is known as pocket veto, when president puts the bill in his pocket and he actually forgets the bill. So even president can apply pocket veto for ordinary bill. Okay, so this was all about ordinary bill. So friends, now let us discuss about money bill. Okay, so first of all, so the first point is that what is the meaning of money bill? So first of all, I will tell you that what is the meaning of money bill. So money bill is a bill which is given under article. So, okay, so money bill is given under article 110 clause 1. Okay, 110 clause 1 sub clause A to sub clause F. Okay, so actually the definition of money bill is given under article 110 clause 1 sub clause A to sub clause F. Or we can also say that the bill given under article 110 clause 1 sub clause A to sub clause F is known as money bill. So what is the meaning of money bill? What is the definition of money bill? So money bill is the bill which is given under article 110 clause 1 sub clause A to sub clause F. Okay. So now what is given in this article 110 clause 1? Okay, and these are the sub clauses, sub clause A to sub clause F. So what is actually given in article 110 clause 1? This we will discuss later on, because actually in this class I have to teach you about all these types of bills. Okay, so later on, please don't worry, later on I will also teach you about that what is actually given under article 110 clause 1 sub clause A to sub clause F. For the time being, you just understand that what is money bill, which bill is known as money bill. So the bill which is given under article 110 clause 1 sub clause A to sub clause F of the Indian Constitution, this type of bill is known as money bill. Okay, now friends, the next question is that where this bill can be introduced. Okay, means can this bill be introduced in Lok Sabha alone, or can this bill be introduced in Rajya Sabha alone, or can this bill be introduced in both the houses? Okay, so the next question is that where this bill can be introduced. Okay, so what is the answer to this question? So the answer to this question is very simple, that this bill can only be introduced in Lok Sabha. So this is the exclusive power of Lok Sabha, that money bill can only be introduced in Lok Sabha. Now what does it mean? It means that money bill cannot be introduced in Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha does not have this power. Money bill cannot be introduced in Rajya Sabha. It can only be introduced in Lok Sabha. Now friends, the next question is that whether the recommendation of president is needed before introduction of money bill in Lok Sabha. Okay, so the next question is regarding the recommendation of president. Okay, means whether the prior approval of president is needed before introduction of this bill, before introduction of money bill in Lok Sabha. So the answer to this question is yes. Okay, means the prior recommendation of president is required for introducing the money bill in Lok Sabha. Okay, so money bill cannot be introduced in Lok Sabha without the prior permission of the president. So the prior permission, the recommendation of the president is needed before introduction of money bill in Lok Sabha. Okay. So friends, now the next question is that what majority is needed for the passing of money bill. Okay, so which type of majority is actually needed for the passing of money bill? So here also the simple majority is needed for the passage of for the passing of मनी बिल. ओके, सो व्हाट इज सिंपल मेजोरिटी? सो आई हैव जस्ट टोल्ड यू सिंपल मेजोरिटी मींस मोर देन 50% ऑफ द मेंबर्स प्रेजेंट एंड वोटिंग. सो दिस सिंपल मेजोरिटी इज एक्चुअली नीडेड फॉर पासिंग द मनी बिल. नाउ फ्रेंड्स, द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द डिस्कशन इन द डिस्कशन ऑफ मनी बिल. सो द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज द लेजिस्लेटिव पावर विद रिस्पेक्ट टू पासिंग द बिल. मीन्स विच हाउस हैज लेजिस्लेटिव पावर विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द पासिंग ऑफ मनी बिल. वेदर लोकसभा हैज मोर पावर्स देन राज्यसभा, और राज्यसभा हैज मोर पावर्स देन लोकसभा, और बोथ द हाउसेज हैव इक्वल पावर इन द पासिंग ऑफ मनी बिल. सो द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज दैट लोकसभा हैज द पावर्स ऑफ लोकसभा. लोकसभा इज मोर पावरफुल देन राज्यसभा इन द मैटर ऑफ द पासिंग ऑफ मनी बिल. ओके, सो व्हाट डज इट मीन? इट मीन्स दैट लोकसभा हैज यूज पावर्स. द पावर्स ऑफ लोकसभा आर वेरी द पावर्स ऑफ लोकसभा आर ह्यूज इन द मैटर ऑफ द पासिंग ऑफ मनी बिल. वेयर एज राज्यसभा हैज नेग्लिजिबल पावर, और वी कैन ऑल्सो से दैट राज्यसभा हैज नो पावर इन द मैटर ऑफ द पासिंग ऑफ मनी बिल. ओके, सो इफ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट मनी बिल, देन वी कैन से दैट इन द मैटर ऑफ द पासिंग ऑफ मनी बिल लोकसभा इज मच मच पावरफुल देन द राज्यसभा. ओके, और वी कैन ऑल्सो से दैट लोकसभा इज वेरी पावरफुल इन द मैटर ऑफ द पासिंग ऑफ मनी बिल देन राज्यसभा. सो द पावर्स ऑफ लोकसभा आर वेरी ह्यूज इन द मैटर ऑफ द पासिंग ऑफ मनी बिल. वेयर एज राज्यसभा हैज नेग्लिजिबल पावर इन द पासिंग ऑफ मनी बिल. ओके, सो इफ वी आर टॉकिंग ऑफ मनी बिल, वेन वी कैन सिंपली से दैट लोकसभा इज वेरी पावरफुल एज कंपेयर टू राज्यसभा, एंड राज्यसभा एक्चुअली हैज नेग्लिजिबल पावर इन द मैटर ऑफ मनी बिल. ओके, सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल हियर यू कैन सी दैट दिस मनी बिल कैन, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दिस मनी बिल कैन ओनली बी इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन लोकसभा. आफ्टर दैट if for example let's suppose that if a money bill is passed by Lok Sabha, okay, so let's suppose friends that if a money bill is passed by Lok Sabha and after that this money bill is sent to Rajya Sabha for its approval. Okay, now friends, if for next 14 days Rajya Sabha does not react on that money bill, okay, if for next 14 days Rajya Sabha does not react on that money bill, then it is considered that the bill is passed by both the houses of parliament. Okay, so here you can see that the powers of Rajya Sabha are negligible. Actually, its approval is not needed. Okay, so just in theory we are saying that the approval of Rajya Sabha is needed. Practically, its approval is not needed. Why? Because even if Rajya Sabha, okay, so now let's suppose even if Rajya Sabha sends this bill back to Lok Sabha for its reconsideration, okay, with some suggestions that Rajya Sabha is giving, many suggestions that this is first, this is second, third, fourth, so these are the four suggestions which should be introduced in this money bill. Okay, so now Lok Sabha has the power to reject all these suggestions. Okay, and if even if Lok Sabha has reject all these suggestions, then also the bill will be passed. Okay, so we can say that the powers of Lok Sabha are very much, okay, Lok Sabha is much powerful. Lok Sabha is very powerful in the matter of money bill. Rajya Sabha has negligible powers. Now friends, what will happen in the case of deadlock? Deadlock means if there is a final disagreement between Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. So here I have just explained you that Lok Sabha is very powerful than Rajya Sabha in the matter of money bill. So here deadlock is not possible. Okay, so here deadlock is not possible. Why deadlock is not possible? Because the powers of Lok Sabha are actually very much in than Rajya Sabha in the matter of money bill. Lok Sabha is very, very powerful than Rajya Sabha in the matter of money bill. So here the deadlock is not possible. Why? Because practically Lok Sabha passes the money bill. Okay, so practically Lok Sabha passes the money bill and Rajya Sabha cannot do anything. Rajya Sabha cannot do anything in the passage of money bill. So here the deadlock is not possible. Why? Because actually Lok Sabha alone is practically passing the money bill. Now friends, after this, let us discuss about the presidential assent. Okay, means when a money bill is passed by the parliament and it is sent to the president, then what happens? Okay, because definitely any bill needs the approval of president for its passing, for it to become a law, for it to be enacted. Okay, so the signature of the presidents are needed. So what happens when a money bill is sent to the president? Now friends, what happens that as per convention, okay, so you have to remember that as per convention, प्रेसिडेंट एक्चुअली गिव्स हिज एसेंट टू द मनी बिल. ओके, सो व्हाट हैपेंस दैट एज पर कन्वेंशन President gives his assent to the money bill. Now, what is the meaning of convention? So, convention basically means tradition. Okay? So, what is convention? So, convention basically means tradition. Means these are the traditions. These are the traditions. These are the customs of the parliamentary form of government. So, as per the tradition, as per the convention of the parliamentary form of government, what happens that president generally gives his assent to the money bill. Okay? But friends, at best, president can also apply absolute veto on the money bill. So here president only has two options. Either he can give his assent as per convention or at best he can apply absolute veto. But friends, for applying absolute veto, the recommendation of the Council of Ministers is needed. So president can only apply absolute veto only on the advice of Union Council of Ministers. So friends, with this, the topic of money bill has also now been completed. Now friends, let us discuss about finance bill category A. Okay, so first of all, we have to discuss that what is the meaning of finance bill category A or finance bill category 1. Okay, so the definition of finance bill category A is given under article 117. Clause 1 of the Indian Constitution. Now, what does it mean? It means that the bill given under Article 117, the bills which are given under Article 117, Clause 1 of the Indian Constitution are known as Finance Bill Category A. So, what is the definition of Finance Bill Category A? So, the bills given under Article 117, Clause 1 of the Indian Constitution are known as finance bill category A. Okay, and what is given in this article? So we will discuss it later on. Okay, because today we have to complete this topic of the bills. Okay, so I will tell you later on that what is the meaning or what is given under article 117 clause 1. Okay, but for the time being, you just understand that which type of bills are known as finance bill category A. So the bills given under article 117 clause 1 of the Indian Constitution are known as finance bill category A. So now friends, then our next question is that where this finance bill category A can be introduced. Okay, so where it can be introduced, whether the finance bill category A can be introduced in Lok Sabha alone, or it can be introduced in Rajya Sabha alone, or it can be introduced in both the houses, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Okay, so the next question is that where this type of bill can be introduced. So the answer to this question is again only Lok Sabha. Okay, so friends, the finance bill category A or finance bill category 1 can only be introduced. Finance bill category A can only be introduced in Lok Sabha. Now, what does it mean? So it means that these type of bills cannot be introduced in Rajya Sabha. Okay. Now friends, let us move to the next question. So the next question is that whether the recommendation of president is needed before the introduction of this bill in Lok Sabha. Okay, so now we know that this bill can only be introduced in Lok Sabha, but now the question is that whether the recommendation of president is needed for the introduction of this type of bill in Lok Sabha. So the answer to this question is also yes. Okay, means the recommendation, the prior permission, prior approval. Okay, so the prior recommendation of the president is needed before the introduction of finance bill category A in the Lok Sabha. Friends, here I want to tell you one thing, that actually notes are not needed for this lecture. So what you have to do, that you have to make this table side by side. Okay, because if I will provide you notes, then I will also make this table. Okay, because I have actually summarized all the type of bills in a table. Okay, so I suggest you to take a copy and pen and just start making this table side by side. So till now, if you have not started making this table, then take a copy and a pen and start making this table side by side, because actually notes are not needed for this lecture. Even if I will provide you notes, then I will also provide you this table, because for simplifying the concept. Okay, actually what happens that if I will teach you this concept in the traditional manner, then it becomes so complex. So what I have decided, that I will make a table, and on this table I will explain you all the type of bills. So actually it becomes very easy to understand these bills by this table method. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to just take a copy and pen and just start making this table side by side, and it will also help you in revision. You can quickly revise with the help of this table. Okay, so I will not provide notes for this specific lecture, because actually notes are not needed. You just need to make a table. So just take a copy and pen and start making table. Okay, now friends, the next question is that what type of majority is needed for the passing of finance bill category A. Okay, so which type of majority is needed for the passing of finance bill category A? So again, the majority here is simple majority. Okay, so which majority is needed? Sir, simple majority is needed for the passage of finance bill category A. And what is the meaning of simple majority? So simple majority means more than 50% of the members present and voting. Okay, now friends, after this, let us discuss about the legislative powers with respect to passing the bill. Okay, now what does it mean? It means that whether Lok Sabha has more powers in the passing of finance bill category A, or Rajya Sabha has more powers in the matter of passing of finance bill category A, or both the houses have equal power in the matter of passing finance bill category A. So what can be the answer to this question? Okay, so the answer to this question is that both the houses, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, have equal power in the matter of the passing of finance bill category A. Okay, so actually Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha have equal power in the matter of the passing of finance bill category A. Neither Rajya Sabha has more powers than Lok Sabha in the matter of finance bill category A, nor Lok Sabha has more power than Rajya Sabha in the matter of finance bill category A. Both the houses, Rajya Sabha as well as Lok Sabha, have equal power in the matter of passing finance bill category A. Okay, now friends, here a question arises that actually you have to ask me that, sir, you have told us that the finance bill category A can only be introduced in Lok Sabha. Okay, and even the recommendation of the president is needed before the introduction of such bill. Okay, and these were the conditions with money bill also. Okay, but you have told us in money bill that Lok Sabha is more powerful than Rajya Sabha, but in the finance bill category A, you are telling us that Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha have equal power. Then why this is so? So the answer to this question is that what happened, friends, that in Rajya Sabha, okay, what happens that in Rajya Sabha, finance bill category A is actually treated like a ordinary bill. Okay, so what happens that in Rajya Sabha, finance bill category A is treated like a ordinary bill. And I have told you that in the matter of ordinary bill, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha have equal powers. And this is the reason why Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha also have equal power in the matter of passing finance bill category A. Okay, so what happens that actually in Rajya Sabha, finance bill category A is treated like a ordinary bill. Okay, so you have to listen this carefully, because this can be even asked in your prelims exam, like that which of the following bills is treated like ordinary bill in Rajya Sabha. Okay, so the answer to the question is that finance bill category A are actually treated like ordinary bill in Rajya Sabha, and this is the reason why Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha have equal power in the matter of the passing of finance bill category A. So friends, now the next question is that what happens in the case of deadlock? Means if there is a final deadlock between Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha over the passing of finance bill category A. Means there is a disagreement between both the houses of parliament. So as I have told you that actually this type of bill is treated like ordinary bill in Rajya Sabha. So what happens that in case of deadlock, joint sitting is arranged. Okay, so if there is any deadlock in the passing of any finance bill category A, then the joint sitting of both the houses of parliament is arranged, and then any decision is actually taken in the joint sitting only. Okay, now friends, let's see the condition of presidential assent. Means when a finance bill category A is passed by Lok Sabha as well as it is passed by Rajya Sabha, then it is sent for the assent of the president. Then what president does? Okay, means when it is sent for the signature of the president, then how many options do president have? So now let us discuss. So friends, here the first option which the president has is that president can give his assent for that bill. Okay, and once the president will sign that bill, so what will happen? That bill will become law. That bill will be enacted. Okay. Now, what is the second option? So the second option is that here president can apply absolute veto on the bill. Absolute veto means president totally denies that I will not sign this bill, I will not give my assent to this bill. But again, the condition is that president can apply absolute veto only on the advice of Union Council of Ministers. So this is the condition here. Now the third option which the president has is that president can even apply suspensive veto. Okay, president can even apply suspensive veto on the finance bill category A. So what happens in suspensive veto? That president actually sends the bill back to the parliament for its reconsideration. President can send the bill back to the parliament for its reconsideration with or without some suggestions. So this happens in suspensive veto. And just like ordinary bill, here also president has the power to apply pocket veto. Okay, so and I have just explained to you that what happens in pocket veto. Okay, so president can also apply pocket veto here. So means president has all the four options in the matter of finance bill category A. And with this, the topic of finance bill category A is also over. So friends, now let us discuss about constitutional amendment bill. So first of all, we have to discuss that what is the meaning of constitutional amendment bill. Okay, so first of all, we will discuss that what is the meaning of constitutional amendment bill. So constitutional amendment bill are the bills given under article 368 of the Indian Constitution. Okay, so which bill is constitutional amendment bill? So the constitutional amendment bill is the bill given under article 368 of the Indian Constitution. Okay, so what is its definition? So actually its definition is given under article 368 capital A. Okay, so what is the definition of constitutional amendment bill, or what is the meaning of constitutional amendment bill? So the bill given under, okay, so the bill which is given under article 368 of the Indian Constitution are known as constitutional amendment bill. Now friends, then we have our next question. So the next question is that where constitutional amendment bill can be introduced. Okay, so where these type of bills can be introduced? So the answer to this question is that constitutional amendment bill can be introduced either in Lok Sabha or it can also be introduced in Rajya Sabha. Okay, means in the matter of the introduction of constitutional amendment bill, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha have equal powers. It can be introduced in Lok Sabha or it can also be introduced in Rajya Sabha. Now friends, after this we have the next question, that whether the recommendation, okay, whether the prior recommendation of the president is needed before the introduction of this bill in parliament. Okay, means if this bill is to be introduced in Lok Sabha, then whether the recommendation of president is needed, or whether if the bill is to be introduced in Rajya Sabha, then whether the recommendation or the permission of president is needed. So the answer to this question is that the recommendation of the president is not required at all. Okay, so the recommendation of the president of India is not required for the introduction of constitutional amendment bill in either house of the parliament. Now friends, then a very important question, that which majority is needed for the passage, for passing the constitutional amendment bill. Okay, so which majority is needed? So the answer to this question is that the special majority is needed for the passing of constitutional amendment bill. Okay, so which majority is needed? A special majority is needed. Now friends, in the class of majority, okay, means in the lecture in which I taught you about majorities, okay, I have told you that there are many type of special majorities. Okay, so which special majority is needed for passing this constitutional amendment bill? So friends, the special majority of more than 2/3 of the members present and voting, and also the absolute majority of the house. Okay, so which majority? Majority, special majority of more than 2/3 of the members present and voting. Okay, and also the absolute majority of the house. Absolute majority of the house, okay, is needed for passing the constitutional amendment bill. Okay, now friends, in the class of majority, means in the class in which I have taught you about the majorities, I have taught you about this type of majority in a much detailed manner. So if any of the student is having confusion, okay, about this type of majority, then I just suggest you to go back and watch that class in which I have taught you about majority. And if you want, okay, if you want, then please come, please let me know in the comment section, then I will even provide you the link of that class in the description of the video, okay? And but I will only put the link of that video in the description only when if the students will ask me to do so in the comment section, okay? But I hope that till now we have discussed about these type of majorities so many times that now they must be on your tips, okay? So which majority is needed? So a special majority of more than 2/3 of the members present in voting, and also the absolute majority of the house. So the special majority of more than 2/3 of the members present and voting, and also the absolute majority of the house is needed for passing the constitutional amendment bill. Now friends, let's move forward to another question. So the next question is that the status of legislative powers with respect to passing the bill. Okay, means in the matter of passing the constitutional amendment bill, whether Lok Sabha is more powerful or Rajya Sabha is more powerful, or whether both the houses are equally powerful. So the answer to this question is that Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha are equally powerful in the matter of passing of constitutional amendment bill. Okay, so the powers of Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha are equal in the matter of passing of the constitutional amendment bill. Now friends, then the next question is that what will happen in the case of deadlock? Deadlock means if there is a final disagreement between both the houses of parliament. Okay, so what will happen in the case of deadlock, in the case of deadlock, if it happens in the case of constitutional amendment bill? So friends, if there is any deadlock between Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha over any constitutional amendment bill, then what will happen? That the bill will be lapsed. Okay, so what will happen? That the bill will be lapsed. So if we are talking about ordinary bill, money bill or finance bill category A, so if there is a deadlock, then what happens? That the joint sitting is what happens friends that in the case of money bill, the deadlock is not possible. Okay, so in the case of money bill, deadlock is not possible. Why? Because Lok Sabha is very powerful than Rajya Sabha in the case of money bill. But if we are talking about ordinary bill and finance bill category A, then if there is any deadlock, if there is any deadlock between Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, then the joint sitting is arranged. But if there is any disagreement between Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, okay, over the passing of constitutional amendment bill, then the joint sitting will not be arranged. Then what will happen? That the bill will be simply lapsed. Okay, so bill will be lapsed. Now friends, after this, let's suppose that a constitutional amendment bill is passed by Lok Sabha, okay, and then it is sent to Rajya Sabha. After that, it is also passed by Rajya Sabha. Then it is sent to the president for his assent, for his signature. So now what happens when a bill is sent for the presidential assent? Okay, so let's see what happens when a bill is sent for, means when a constitutional amendment bill is sent for presidential assent. So friends, what happens? That first of all, president is bound. Okay, president is bound to give his assent to any constitutional amendment bill. Okay, so the first thing is that president is bound to give his signature to any constitutional amendment bill, and at best he can apply absolute veto. Okay, so at best he can apply absolute veto, but he can apply absolute veto only on the recommendation of Union Council of Ministers. Okay, so only on the recommendation of Union Council of Ministers he can apply absolute veto, otherwise he has to give his assent to the constitutional amendment bill. Now friends, with this, the topic of constitutional amendment bill is also completed. Now friends, now only one more bill is left. And what is that bill? So that bill is finance bill category B. Okay, so now only one bill is left, and the name of this bill is finance bill category B, or you can also call it finance bill category 2. Okay, so now friends, what is the meaning of finance bill category B or finance bill category 2? Okay, so what is the meaning? What is the definition? So finance bill category B or finance bill category 2 are given under article 117 क्लॉज 3 ऑफ द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. सो विच बिल्स आर नोन एज फाइनेंस बिल कैटेगरी बी और फाइनेंस बिल कैटेगरी 2? सो द बिल्स गिवन अंडर आर्टिकल 117 क्लॉज 3 ऑफ द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन आर नोन एज द फाइनेंस बिल कैटेगरी बी और फाइनेंस बिल कैटेगरी 2. Now friends, after this, why I have not listed this bill in this table? So the reason is that this finance bill category B or this finance bill category 2 are just like the ordinary bill. Okay, so the finance bill category B or finance bill category 2 are just like ordinary bill. Now what does it mean? It means that first of all, in which house of the parliament they can be introduced? So they can be introduced in either in Lok Sabha or in Rajya Sabha. Finance bill category B can be introduced either in Lok Sabha or in Rajya Sabha. Now which majority is needed to pass this bill? So the simple majority is needed for passing the finance bill category B. Now after this, the next parameter is that which house is more powerful in the matter of passing the finance bill category B. So the answer is that Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha are equally powerful in the matter of passing of finance bill category B. Okay, so both the houses have equal power. Now what about presidential assent? So here also president has four options. The first option is that president can give his assent. Okay, first option is president can give his assent. Second option is that president can apply absolute veto on the recommendation of Union Council of Ministers. Third option is that president can even apply suspensive veto. Okay, and after that the fourth option is that president can even apply pocket veto. Okay, so what I just want to explain that finance bill category B are just like ordinary bill. Okay, so if you know what is ordinary bill, then you also know what is finance bill category B. Okay, so they are just like ordinary bill. Okay, they are just like ordinary bill, but there is a one difference. Okay, and actually you have to study about that difference. There is only a one difference in these bills. Okay, means there is a one difference between ordinary bill and finance bill category B. And what is that difference? Now that difference is regarding the recommendation of president before the introduction of bill. Now I have told you that the finance bill category B can be introduced in either house of the parliament. Okay, so it can be introduced in Lok Sabha as well as it can be introduced in Rajya Sabha. But friends, the thing is that the recommendation of the president is needed. Okay, the recommendation of the president is required before the introduction of finance bill category B in either house of the parliament. Okay, so before introducing finance bill category B in either house of the parliament, the recommendation of president is required. But this recommendation is actually not required in the case of ordinary bill. Okay, but in the case of finance bill category B, the recommendation of president is required if it is to be introduced in either house of the parliament. So friends, with this, all the bills are now completed. Okay, so the topic of bill is now completed. So friends, I hope that you all must have made this table side by side. And if you have not made this table so far, so then just take a screenshot of this screen. Okay, just take a screenshot and note down this table in your notebook. Okay, so no notes are needed for this lecture. Why? Because even if I will provide you the notes, then I will also provide you this table. So better approach is that you note down. Okay, you note down this table in your notebooks. Okay, so I will not provide notes for this specific lecture only. Okay, so I am talking about this specific lecture only. Why? Because there is no need. Okay, there is no need. You just take your notebook and note down this table. So friends, I hope that you all must have enjoyed the lecture. And if you have enjoyed the lecture, then please like the video, comment, subscribe the channel, press the bell icon and select all. And tell about this channel to all the people you know who are preparing for UPSC or any other state PSC. Now friends, we will meet in next class. Till then, take care of yourself. Thank you.